Hey guys, Civilian Soldier 762 here, and today I'm gonna show you guys part two of AKs for beginners, for someone who is new to the AK platform and has just got one and wants to smooth their rifle out a little bit, make the action smoother, make the trigger a little bit better, just things like that. So first off, we'll start with making the action smoother. And to do that, the first thing you're going to want to do is remove your hammer. And what you'll do is these two wires here, that hold the spring tension in, I use a screwdriver and I just flip them up and cross them over the hammer like that. And the part of the hammer that the sear and the trigger hook catches, you'll put them on, and I always use a twist tie and twist tie them once I got them on there, because those things hurt like a bastard, and they'll snap off and get you in the finger, and you do that a few times and you won't let that happen anymore. So once you do that, you'll take your retaining wire out. A lot of AKs have different types. Some of them have a shepherd's crook that on the safety here is attached, and then it goes down and covers your access pin for your trigger and for your hammer. Some of them, it's through the front there and comes, so you just have to take that out. The ones I have are through the front, but you can just take a screwdriver and basically lift it up and set it over where it's not on the groove of your access pins, and then you should just be able to push your access pin right out, take your trigger and hammer out. So I'm gonna, since I only got one hand here, I'm gonna stop the camera, take my retaining wire out, and then I'll get back to you. Okay, I got my retaining wire out, or shepherd's crook, or whatever you want to call it. And one thing I forgot to mention is the only tools you need for this job really is a screwdriver, possibly a punch and a hammer, depending on how easy or hard it is for your access pins to come out. Sometimes you can just push them right out like this trigger pin. See how it just pushed through? And I can pull it out the back sides probably. But if not, if they're hard to get out, just take your punch. Then you can usually just push it through. Like the hammer one is usually harder than the trigger. So what you might have to do is put your, and if you don't have a punch, you can use anything really, screwdriver, just anything basically to knock that pin out. And if you have a cleaning kit, if your AK came with a cleaning kit, you have a punch. And this punch is actually used for a lot of things on these rifles. Like this one came with this underfolder here, and it's used to disassemble the underfolder stock. It's used to drift the pins for the front sight block, for the gas block. Basically, anywhere that's pinned on this rifle, this punch will work for. So I'll go ahead and knock this pin out, because it's probably gonna be a little bit harder to do, and I won't be able to do it one-handed. But all I'm gonna do is put the punch there and just tap it with a hammer, and it'll drive right out. Now, your hammer with your spring attached will come right out, and your trigger group will come out. And in your trigger group, this one's a Tapco G2, so it's actually got this sleeve that holds the sear to the trigger group itself, and it holds your spring in there that allows the sear to move. Some triggers like the factory triggers that come with like parts kits don't have that sleeve in it. Just the access pin is what holds the sear in there. But once you got those out, go ahead and show you the next step here. Clean this stuff out of the way real quick. Okay, so here is the Tapco G2, and here is the Military Surplus Tapco trigger and sear. And basically, for the way this works is, say you're shooting, you pull the trigger, shoot, you're still holding the trigger. The hammer strikes your bolt. Here, let me get this here. The hammer strikes the bolt, the firing pin, and then the whole bolt carrier itself with the bolt cycles back, knocks the hammer back, and you just shot, you're still holding the trigger. The sear right here will engage the hammer. Okay, and then now you've shot, you let off the trigger to reset the trigger. So you let off, and then the trigger hook catches the hammer. And now you're ready for your next shot. You shoot again. The hammer strikes the bolt, the firing pin, and then comes back and does it again. Now, if you're the type of person that you don't follow through with your trigger and you just pull it, let go, what'll likely happen is it's gonna hit that, come back and catch just the trigger hook. But you're gonna polish, if you want to smooth your trigger out, basically what you're gonna polish is this trigger hook. You don't want to take any material off, just that edge underneath, the part that contacts the hammer face. You'll just polish it, make it really smooth and shiny, and you'll also do that to the flat part of the hammer, make that smooth and shiny right there, and that'll give you a smoother trigger pull. But with like the Tapco G2 trigger, it's really got a really light, pretty decent trigger anyway, and that's what most AKs will come with, unless you have like an Arsenal AK, and they have the Arsenal two-stage trigger. And then if you want to, you can polish the bottom part of your sear and the back part there just to give you a smoother trigger reset, but that really isn't going to do a whole lot for you. The main thing is just polishing the bottom part of your hook and polishing that part right there on your hammer. And then the most important thing for all this is smoothing your action out. On a lot of AKs, a tendency they have is you'll go to pull the bolt back, and then you can just slowly ride it, let go, and the bolt will stick. And that happens on all types of rifles, entry level to high end ones. And a lot of people attribute that to the rifle, and really what that is it's the hammer itself. The way most US trigger group or hammers come, this one I've reprofiled, see how it's rounded? The way they come, it's actually squared. It comes up, straight, and down like a stop sign. And what you'll do, you can kind of see that squareness there, is I used a Dremel. And just, you're not going to take a ton of material off, you're just going to round it and polish it really, really smooth, where it's super smooth. And that will keep the bolt carrier from hanging up. Because what happens, it doesn't matter, how much you paid for your rifle, what brand it is, it has nothing to do with the rifle, it's the trigger or the hammer in the rifle. You can have a $3,000 perfect rifle and put a Tapco G2 trigger in it, and likely it will hang up. Because first your bolt will hit the hammer, and then this part right here on your carrier is what will hang up when you're easing it forward. I mean, just tapping the rifle or shaking it, usually a little nudge and it will slam home. But it's just irritating for some people. And you know, you want a smooth action on your rifle. So you'll just polish that face round the edges to where they are not squared off anymore. Because here is a parts kit hammer. You can see it doesn't have the squared edges like the US hammers do usually. It's more round and it seems to cycle a lot better, smoother. So I just kind of copied that with this. But you'll do that, and then also on the contact point on the bottom of your bolt carrier, right there, the edge that catches your hammer and the part that rides across it, you'll polish that as smooth as you possibly can, and the part of the bolt that rides across it. And you don't want to change the dimensions or like, you know, the angle or anything like that. You're not taking material off this at all. You're just polishing it. You're just smoothing it out and making it shiny and just to where it feels really smooth to the touch. The hammer face is where you'll take the material off of. But that will make your rifle feel a million times better. And then, you know, you do the trigger and the hammer and the bolt carrier bolt, and you'll have just a really smooth functioning rifle. And that's something easy and worthwhile to do to every AK, no matter what kind it is. If you guys have any questions, just let me know. And I might make another video showing refinishing the rifles, you know, refinishing the furniture, repainting them. Because a lot of AKs come with just an ugly Parkerized finish or not that great of a finish on them. And for very low cost, you can refinish it and make it look really nice. And a lot of these modifications don't cost you anything to do, really. All you need is a Dremel to do them. And if you don't have a Dremel, what you can use is a file, and you use a file to reprofile your trigger or your hammer face, and just, you know, be careful not to take too much material off, and then use like a fine grit sandpaper and just keep going finer and finer to polish it until it's, you know, a really smooth, shiny surface. I even used a really, really fine grit sandpaper after I had finished mine with the Dremel and then polished it with the buffing wheel. But with just the smooth fine grit sandpaper, it made it super smooth. So that's really all you need. You know, there's a lot of things you can do with these rifles to make them look a lot nicer and function, you know, just smoother, you know, cycle smoother, smoother to operate without spending really any money. So here's some shout outs to some really good small channels to check out. First, we got Super Atari 2600. He's an awesome guy, got a really cool channel. He does a lot of the hangouts and stuff like that, so check him out. Okay, we got Russian Filipino. He's been a friend of mine on YouTube basically since I started. He's a great guy and could use your guys' support. So I recently just found out about these guys, the Glock Brothers. They're really funny and have a bunch of great information on their channel, so check those guys out also. Another newer small channel is the AK Guru. He's got some really awesome AKs, and I can't wait to see him make some videos of them and put them up. Another small gun channel that I really enjoy is Zero Cipher 7, Zero Cipher 7, sorry. Definitely worth checking out. And last but definitely not least is Mule Team 66. Just a great guy. Been friends with him for a long time, since the beginning of my YouTube career, basically. Really entertaining and definitely worth checking out. So in my last video, I gave a shout out to Jacob of Washington, and I accidentally linked the wrong profile to another guy, so I just wanted to make sure that everyone that wanted to sub him, that I'll put the link in this one and actually get it right this time. So I'm sorry about that, brother. You know, he's got a good channel, so really check him out. He deserves the subs. He's only got a few right now.